Along with Rome and Jerusalem, Santiago de Compostela is one of the most important spiritual places of the Christian world. Between the years of 820 to 830, the tomb of St. James, one of the 12 apostles of God, was found in Galicia, Spain. Due to his death, there were many people from all over the world that wanted to visit the tomb, and therefore a route was created. This route started in France, in Saint Jean Pied de Port. This is the original route, however, there are other many routes such as El Camino Primitivo. To help the pilgrim get to the tomb, bridges, monasteries, and hospitals were created. As the years went on, more people from all over the world wanted to see the tomb, and therefore new routes were also created. Of the 850 kilometers that the French Camino takes up, me, my mom, and my friend are going to cover the last 116 kilometers of the way, starting in the small village of Sarria. We have decided that we are going to do it walking, which means that we need to walk at least 100 kilometers to get the pilgrim's passport. There are other people that choose to do the way by horse or by bike, which means that they need to cover 100 and 200 kilometers respectively. We're planning to take 6 days to finish this distance, starting the 3rd of July and walking an average of 20 kilometers per day. It is July 2nd and we are starting our journey in the Madrid-San Martin train station. We are heading off to Sarria, 6 hours away, where we will start walking to our destination, Santiago de Compostela. Welcome to Sarria. Before starting our trip tomorrow, we will now visit the small village of Sarria, which contains quite a few monuments, such as this church, which is the main building of this village. This is the Church of Santa Maria of the 19th century, which is located in Sarria, where we will start our journey. This street here takes us to the next church of San Salvador of the 13th century. This is a church of San Salvador from the 13th century. And that over there is the castle. This is a cruzeiro, which is made up by a granite cross, and its origins date back to the 14th century and was developed further in the 17th century. There is at least one of them in each village, and therefore we will see lots of them in our way to Santiago. A very traditional thing that many pilgrims do is to buy a shell and either put it on the walking stick or bag. This shell represents and symbolizes the good actions of God towards the people. Welcome to the second day of the trip, first day walking. Today we'll be walking from here, Sarria, to Puerto Marín, which is 24 kilometers away. This is the way we will be going. We are now heading off towards the outside of the village as we pass through another cruzeiro. After already walking 6 kilometers, we have reached the 110 kilometers mark to Santiago de Compostela. On On the way, you can find all types of people, and even cows, as we are seeing before arriving to our first stop for the day, Barbadello.
This is our first stop of the day in Barbadello. This is a Romanic temple that is in Barbadello that was built in the 12th century. Next to this, there used to be a monastery, but it's now not here anymore.
This is the famous fountain in Rente, which was built in the Jacobeo of 1993. Jacobeo is the year when the day of Santiago is a Sunday. The pond next to the fountain is where people used to swim when it was really hot.
I'm from South Korea.
Do you think like this teaches you something about the culture of Spain?
Yeah, I think it's only my first day, right? Because we started in Sevilla, but I think it's very nice to see people from all over the world, mostly from Spain, but from all over the world being very nice to each other, saying hi, helping each other out. Like, I like the atmosphere, and it's very nice. I think it does save it, yeah.
Okay. Hope you enjoy.
You too.
Thank you. We have finally arrived to Puerto Marín, the destination for today. The last 5 kilometers have been very tiring, but we have finally made it. We are in the Church of Puerto Marín, one of the most significant places in this small town. Here we are, it's our third day, the second day walking, and today we'll be going from Puerto Marín to Palas de Rey, another 24 kilometers. Today we will start going down this way.
As we are walking by, we are thinking that we are not going to see anything interesting, but as we go up the small hill and look to the right, we see a pile granary standing.
We are arriving to the halfway point of the day. We have woken up early, and as you can see, there's a lot of people marching.
This is the Church of Gonsar, the first stop for the day. This is a Romanic temple, which is also a church that is dedicated to Santa Maria. Close to the high altar, the tomb of Josefa de la Torre, or the stick woman of Gonsar, is located. We are now in Lestedo, visiting another church with a crucero and a cemetery around it. We can see that all the churches that we have seen so far are similar, Romanic and with either one or two bells on top. We are finally seeing the first group of people doing the Camino by bike, and I think that these are not going to be the last ones we see.
After walking 25 kilometers and almost 7 hours, we have finally arrived to our destination, Palas de Rey. Today has been much harder than yesterday.
We are now in Palas de Rey, in the only church that there is. This church is quite big and also Romanic, as all the ones we have seen so far during our journey. However, this church does not contain either one or two bells on top.
Here we are on a third day walking. Today we'll be going from Palas de Rey to Melide. Today is a short walk of only 15 kilometers, but as you can see, we have woken up and it's kind of drizzling. We hope the rain does not stop us.
As you can see, the weather is not with us today. It is cold, the floor is wet, and we have our covers on our back because it is raining. As we are arriving to our first stop for the day, we pass through a church that has a chain attached to the bell, and we decide to make it sound. The day is clearing off, and the sun is starting to appear. It is getting quite warm, so we decide to take off our jersey. We are now in Leboreiro, a small village. This is the church of the Virgen de las Nieves. Next to this church, there used to be a hospital for the pilgrims, made by the warrior family in the 12th century. The most significant building of this family is the Paso de Huaya, located 5 kilometers from the village. We are now near Melide and about to pass through a famous bridge.
Finally arrived to our destination for today, Melide. Today has been an easy day with no rain after all, with only 15 kilometers and around 3.5 to 4 hours walking. The bridge will take us to the city of Melide, where we will stay tonight. Here in Melide there are many churches. This is one of the most significant ones. This is the Church of Santa Lucia de Melide.
A very traditional thing to eat in this region of Spain is octopus, and this is how they cook it. As we visit the main monuments of Melide, including the city council, the museum, and the main church, we realize that we are halfway there through our journey, and we have met a lot of people from all parts of the world.
Hello, we are Jorge, Silvia and Vicente. We are from Madrid and we are walking the Camino de Santiago.
We are from the United States, Colorado.
We're doing the Camino de Santiago.
My name is Wade,
and I'm from Shanghai. I'm doing the Camino from San Juan to Santiago.
My name is Jacqueline, and I'm from a small town in Moat in Westmeath in Ireland. And we're just doing a very short part of the way.
Hi. Hello, we're from Brussels, Belgium, and we are making the way.
Hello.
We are from South Korea.
Annyeong.
Here we are, it's our fourth day walking, another rough morning with some rain, but we are finally on the way to Arsua. Today will be an easy day of only around 14 kilometers.
In the outside of Melide, we found a local market where they sell both fruits and vegetables. Just a few kilometers after leaving, we find a crucero and a church that are in the outside of Melide. In addition to the yellow arrows that mark the way, there are other resources that have been used to do so. As we are getting closer to Arthua, there is not much to see on the way, and therefore we are enjoying the views.
After walking 4 hours and around 14 kilometers, we have finally arrived to the city that we will be on, Arthua. This is the Magdalena Chapel in Arthua, built in the 14th century. Only 2 more days to go. Today is our 4th day. Today we'll be going from Arthua to Arca do Pino. The weather today is not very good, as you can see. There's quite a lot of fog and it's pretty cold. So let's hope the rain does not hit us. Today we'll be doing around 18 kilometers, which will probably take us 6 hours.
We are now heading off towards the outside of Arthua as we pass through the main church of this village. The day is clearing off and the sun is coming out, but as the kilometers decrease, we are in a situation like yesterday, because we are not seeing anything special, such as churches, monasteries or hospitals. All we are seeing are some small monuments and the landscape.
We are now arriving to our destination for today, only a few kilometers left. After walking 6 hours and around 20 kilometers, we have finally arrived to our destination for today. We are in the city of Arca do Pino, where we will stay tonight. Tomorrow we will finally reach our destination, Santiago de Compostela, where we'll finalize our journey. In Arca do Pino, this is the only church here. The rest of the city are just some hostels because it is very small. Here we are. It's our last day walking today. Today we'll be going from Arca do Pino to our destination, Santiago de Compostela. Today we'll do around 20 kilometers and we will reach the Cathedral of Santiago.
We are getting closer and closer to Santiago de Compostela, but there's something strange. As it is the last day, there's supposed to be a lot of people walking around us. But as you can see, there's not many people doing so. It's only us and some other people. We are now in the Mount of Joy, the highest place from where you can see Santiago de Compostela. From now on, all the road is downward. As you can see, there's a lot of people resting here, and that's why we didn't see them before. Now that we're in Santiago de Compostela, you can see how many people there are arriving to the cathedral, which is a few meters away.
Walking. And 110 kilometers, we have finally reached our destination. Just to the left, after this street, we can find the Cathedral of Santiago, which is our destination for this journey. Here we are, we have arrived. To the left of this staircase, we will see the Cathedral of Santiago de Compostela. Unfortunately, the main building is under repair, but it's still good. Mass in the cathedral at 12. We are now in the Pilgrim's Mass in the cathedral. This Mass is celebrated every day at 12 p.m. for all the pilgrims that are arriving to Santiago de Compostela. As you can see, it is full of people. All the ones that are arriving to Santiago yesterday and today. This is a bota fumeiro, which contains incense inside it. This is not done in every pilgrim's mass, so we are lucky that they're doing it now. And this is by far the best moment of today's mass. To be able to get the pilgrim's passport, we needed to stamp our credentials, this small booklet, at least 2 times every day through our journey. As you can see, I have filled up almost the whole booklet, so I will now proceed to get my pilgrim's passport.
I'm Kim.
My name is
Han. We come from South Korea. Very glad to meet you guys, and hopefully you enjoyed your life and take a good movie and then to be famous movie director.
Our journey has finally ended. We're leaving Santiago and we're going back to Madrid, thinking and wondering if we should come back and do it next year. Thank you.